everyone, welcome back to the channel. My name is Jake, this channel is called Jake of All Trades, and today I am going to be checking out a band I have never checked out before. It's called Velvet Sighs. Now, I do not know how you sigh velvetly. But, bad dad jokes aside, this one, Parker seems to think that this one's really worth checking out. Because he voted for it 25 times on several different videos. And then Tefezix, who apparently isn't really familiar with them, is just like, yeah, sure, and put in two okay votes for that. So, I don't know, I'm not sure what to expect. There's some mention of, like, 90s alternative style, so that should be pretty interesting. I see the official music video listed here, as well as something on Music Gold Rush. It looks like it might be a live version, so if that is indeed a live version of the song, I will certainly be including it in this reaction and make it a compare and contrast and have some fun with it. I also trapped my cat in the office, or one of my cats in the office, so she may or may not pop up from time to time, or just beg me to leave the office, so who knows. But anyway, without any further ado, let's get into Velvet Sighs, Pretending. Okay, Pretending by Velvet Sighs, here we go. Certainly hear it already. Yeah, something's definitely wrong. Huh. All right. Sorry, this isn't going the way that it should. Go figure. It's frozen now. I'm going to come back in a second.
2 hours later.
Okay. So I let my computer rest for a little while and cool down. So I'm going to start this from the beginning. So obviously I've heard a little bit of the track already. So hopefully this time everything will be synced up right. No lagging, no nothing. Let's give this a second go. Here we go. I mentioned in my first run through that I definitely get the 90s or 90s vibe, but it's more polished. Definitely seems better saves this time. That was the end. Oh. Okay, I did not see that coming. Holy cow. I thought we were just reaching the middle of the song. I thought it was still more to go. Holy cow. Okay, so this is Velvet Size pretending on Music Gold Rush. Again, I do not know if this is going to be what I think it's going to be. I hope it is what I think it's going to be. A good quality live version that gives me some a chance to do some comparisons and contrasts. So here we go, without any further ado. Okay. Okay, so it seems like it's going to be a decent quality live version here. Crank the volume a little bit. Performs really well too. I noticed she's using the grit more sparingly in live. Nice pace lines. Nice to just have a drum and bass section instrumentally here. Seems like she's pushing a lot harder now. Little run. A nice little float that she had there. Curious. You can't just have the guitar solo fade out here. Okay, so he didn't just have it, like, he didn't extend it, they seemed to cut it a little short, okay.
さあ、それでは前列の方からお話を伺っていきます。よひとさん、どうでしたか？
I don't know what this part's about. I cannot read Japanese. Okay, all right, so thank you for bearing with me through my technical difficulties on my first run through. If you made it this far in the video, I appreciate you sticking around. So, anyway, yeah, I definitely got that 90s kind of, alternative grunge vibe, I'm glad I got a chance to do the comparisons and or the live and the studio version, so I can do a little bit of a comparison and contrast. The first thing, the first difference I can hear between the two different performances was just the singer. I don't know her name yet, but she was like really gritty throughout the entire song in the studio version. Whereas in the live version, you could definitely tell she was kind of saving it a little bit. But as she went on, it seemed like she was pushing a lot more. And I don't, I'm not sure if that was intentional or if she just kind of was getting to the point of like, she's just giving it her all at that point. And, you know, I've certainly had some performances like that where I'm just kind of like at the end of my rope and I'm just pushing as hard as I can to just keep going. So I don't know if that's exactly what she had going on, but she still sounded great. It sounded very good. A couple pitchy points, but like in that sort of, in this sort of style, with like a kind of, 90s grungy, you know, I don't want to say garage band sort of thing, but like kind of sort of along that line, like perfection isn't necessary. And actually, perfection is almost like your downfall in this sort of style. Like, if you have a little bit of that rawness, that that a little bit of pitchiness, a little bit of like even some breaks here and there, or like just some like scratchiness to the guitar tone, that is like part of the style. And I think I almost prefer the live version because of that, because you know, it's not that lack of polishness, like, just gives it more of that character and gives it more of that signature, like, that's, it's a, I'm struggling to find the right words for this, that lack of perfection gives it more of its character. So I think it's better live, personally. I was definitely thrown off by that guitar solo at the end. I thought, oh, we're getting to the middle of the song, and I didn't realize it was already 4 minutes. Like, it just passed by so quickly because it's like, it was just very engaging. And so when you had this guitar solo fading out, like, wait, are we done? Are we done already? Seriously? And I was curious if the lead guitarist was going to continue to keep going and just kind of give you like a non-faded out version of the solo, and it didn't seem like he did that. It sounded like they cut it off a little bit sooner, which is fine. I mean, you need to make some kind of compromise when you're doing a live performance. So it is what it is. I kind of wish they would have extended it a little further. That would have been cool. Just hear how he meant for that solo to go, you know, without it fading out into nothingness. So. Parker, I definitely appreciate you bringing this to my attention and voting for it a bunch of times to get me to actually react to it and analyze it. Because you know, I've gotten some other requests here and there for other bands, but it's just like one request, and it's like I'd love to get to it. It's just that, you know, the more votes, the higher priority. So thank you for pushing this one up. It was definitely a nice experience. That's all I can think of for now. I'd certainly love to discuss it more at some point and revisit it. But that's it for now. Thank you so much for watching. If you haven't already liked the video, subscribe to the channel, turn on all notifications so that you don't miss anything going forward. And if you have any other bands or other songs from Velvet Size that you'd like to see me check out, certainly leave it in the comments below, and I will give you a shout out when I end up doing the video. And the more comments you leave, the more votes you get. So do that down there and make me have some fun. Also, if you have any requests for guitar covers or vocal covers you'd like to see me do, leave those in the comments as well, and I will give you a shout out when I do that video. Thank you to BM for Life for supporting me on Patreon. I really appreciate it. Again, I do this for fun, and the fact that you see me worthy enough to support me on Patreon is just, it just means a lot. I really, really appreciate that. So that's all for today. Thank you so much. Enjoy the rest of your day and rock on. Oh, and God bless you and rock on.